ومن أعرض عن ذكري فإن له معيشة ضنكا ونحشره يوم القيامة أعمى.
تقال العثار العظام به ويغدو الهوى ككبش ذبيح بذكر الإله.
Allah is a great honor. That's the goal in life. And Allah pre-programmed that goal inside every single human being. But if you lose sight of that goal, it is like this, you know, you have this thirst, this hunger inside you to fulfill that goal. Allah created you with that. But when your appetite is not filled with healthy food, what do you fill it with? If you don't get the right meal, are you going to say, I'm not going to eat at all? No. When a person is starving and there's no food of their preference, or there's no healthy food, there's even filth, barks of trees, will the human being still start chewing on that when it comes to that? They will. When you lose sight of Allah Azza wa Jal, and that no longer is your goal, then necessarily you will find a replacement. Necessarily. It is necessary to have something you aspire towards. That is the mission of your life. So the one who has found Allah, what happens to them? Inna salati wa nusuki wa mahyaya wa mamati lillahi rabbil alameen. It's very simple for them. The one who has really found Allah, their salah is for Allah, their sacrifice is for Allah, their life and their death is now for Allah. The way they live, the way they eat, the way they sleep, what they want to do with their life, their long-term goals, their short-term goals, what are they going to do with their kids, why are they getting an education, where are they going to work, everything is now for Allah, that is their goal. But for the one who doesn't have that goal, they have to find another goal. And in old times there used to be idols, there used to be other religions, you find some other god. But in our times it's become far more pathetic. Far more pathetic. Now you have someone who's obsessed with their body and they're working out 18 hours a day. And their only goal in life is to just keep getting buffer and buffer. It's the only goal. Take steroids and look sharp, stay on top, keep in shape. Or there's this goal they set with their trainer. I gotta do this many reps, or I gotta do this many push-ups, or I gotta get bench press this many pounds, etc. That's their goal. That has become their ilah. For a person that their life has become about money. Have you met people? They cannot talk about anything except their work. They can't. Yeah, I work at this company, I do this. And the moment they lose their job, they become suicidal. Because that's all they ever thought about. That's all they ever did with their life. That's all they ever did. That becomes their goal. For some people, it's their children. They live for their children. They do everything for their children. Day and night they think about their children. There is no other thought running in their mind. There is no other goal before them than their children. That is all they run after. When you don't find him, you will find something else. You will find something else and you will run after it. And you will give your life to it. And there is no exception among human beings. And today it could be even a slacker. You could ask me, what about a slacker? You know those kids that play 20 hours of video games a day and don't get off the couch? Well, what is their goal? It is to entertain themselves. It is to fry their brain cells behind a screen. That is their ultimate goal. That is what they want to reach. And they're working hard to attain it every day. Right? That's what it becomes. These are the psychological implications of understanding Tawheed. It is easy to say Allah is one. But is He one in my life? Is he the one for me? Or do I have some other one that I'm running after? Or some other thing that I put before myself? Allah asked this question rhetorically. He says, مَا غَرَّكَ بِرَبِّكَ الْكَرِيمِ. What deluded you from your gracious master? What was so important to you that you ran after, that you couldn't come after this?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.